स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप एवरीवन इज इन गुड हेल्थ। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर लेसन मैटर इन विच आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे स्टेट्स एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर। वी नो दैट मैटर एग्जिस्ट इन थ्री डिफरेंट स्टेट्स और थ्री डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स। व्हाट आर द थ्री डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ मैटर? वन इज सॉलिड, वन इज लिक्विड एंड वन इज गैस। देयर आर थ्री डिफरेंट स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर। First, we will discuss in details about solid. So, what is solid? Solid have a definite mass, definite shape and definite volume. What is the meaning of definite? Definite means fixed. It is not going to change. Suppose it is a solid. If I keep on this board, then what happened? This takes some space, fixed shape. If I keep on the floor also, then also it will this space only. That means fixed volume. Volume means what? Space occupied by a object. And definite mass means what? It has a fixed mass. Wherever you will weigh it, it will weigh the same. Suppose it is 10 gram, then it will weigh 10 gram everywhere, wherever you take in this atmosphere. Now we talk about the shape. Shape is also fixed. You can see that wherever I keep, it will have this shape only. Okay? So these are mean by definite mass, definite shape and definite volume. What is the molecular arrangement? Because we know that any forms of matters are made up of atoms and molecules. So, what is the arrangement of the molecules inside the solid? The molecules are closely packed. Let us see with the help of a diagram. Small diagram I am doing. Suppose this is a solid. Okay, the molecules are closely, very closely packed. Very less distance will be there between the molecules. And all the molecules in a given elements, all the molecules will be alike. Alike means they are all same. So, what is the arrangement of the molecule? They are all closely packed. Can you see? They are closely packed, very close to each other. And what is this? I have written in a short way, but because you have learned in the previous video session that what is IMFA, intermolecular force of attraction. You know, in a solid, intermolecular force of attraction is very strong, because that's why they are attracted towards each other and it is very difficult to pull them from each other. Okay, why it is difficult to pull them from each other? We need a strong heating to make them move. So, intermolecular force of attraction is very strong. That's why we cannot pull them. And what is IMS? Intermolecular space or gap. Intermolecular space is very less. You can see there is no negligible gap between them. Okay, so the intermolecular space is very less. We can say that these are the three molecular arrangement of the solid. Now we will talk about the properties. Properties are what? They are very rigid. Rigid means very tight and packed. You can see from here, that's why they are very rigid. They cannot be easily broken and give any definite shape you want. Any desired shape you cannot give. Next is the definite volume. I have already told you definite volume means fixed volume it will occupy wherever you keep. Retain their shape. Retain their shape means the molecules always try to come back to their original position. After that, have you seen elastic rubber band? When you stretch them, again it come back to its original. A sponge, when you press them, again you release them, the sponge come back to its original. So, because they retain their shape. Almost incompressible. Incompressible depends upon which type of solid you have taken. Solids are of two types, hard solid and soft solid. So, hard solid if you take like gold, iron, diamond, wood, then they are incompressible. But if you take about rubber band, then balloon, then sand. So, these are what? These are slightly compressible. Okay, most of them are incompressible. Now about the free surface, you can see that all the molecules are attached to the surface, okay, the side molecules are attached to the surface, so any number of free surface we get from the solid, that means there is no fix, that you can take from here also any molecule, here from and here from, four sides are open for it, any number of free surfaces are present in a solid. The last point we will discuss about the pressure. You know that it is incompressible, most of the solid. When you give a pressure to the hard solid, it will be incompressible. But when you give a pressure to the soft solid, like sponge, rubber band, balloons, so it will what happen? It will be a slightly little bit incompressible can be done. So it depends upon which type of solid you are taking. So pressure depends upon the types of solid. So any example you can take, I have given 3-4 example, you can take more than that also. Sugar, wood, sand, iron, diamond, these are the common example we come across of solid. Now let us talk about the next state of matter. The second state of matter is liquid. Now liquid has a definite mass but no definite shape. It takes the shape of the container in which it is kept. Suppose if I keep the liquid, suppose I take water, then if I keep the water in a glass, it will take the shape of the glass. If I take the water in a bottle, then it will take the shape of the bottle. If I take it in a cup, then it will take the shape of the cup. That's why we say that it has no definite shape. It takes the shape of the container. Now about the volume, it occupies the fixed volume. That means if I take a cup of water, then it will take only minimum space area, how much the cup of water can be flowed. It cannot be a bucket of water. Okay, so volume will not increase. Okay, if you change the container, volume will not increase. So volume will remain the same. Okay, now let us see what is the molecular arrangement of a liquid. Molecular arrangement we are going to say by comparing with the solid. In the solid we have seen the molecules are closely packed, very tightly packed. But in the liquid you see that we don't find any compactness in them. There is a slight gap in them. Okay, that's why molecules are not so closely packed like the solid. So there is a gap between them. Next will be the molecular force of attraction will be not very strong as solid. So since they have the gap, so a molecular force of attraction will be not so strong as we find in the solid. Similarly, the gap between them is increased compared to the solid. So we can say intermolecular space is little more than solid. So these are the molecular arrangement of this. Okay. Now we come to the properties of the liquid. Since we have told that no definite shape is there, so it has no definite shape. It takes the shape of the container in which it is kept. Definite volume. Suppose I take a cup of water. Okay. It is full here. Okay, the water is full here, but if I take a bottle and put the same amount of water here, if I pour it here, then what will happen? It will take hardly this much space. And if I take a bucket, big bucket, okay, and if I want to put this water again to this, then hardly it will take this much space. That means what? That means the volume is not increasing if I change the container from big to small. It is fixed. Now coming to the flow from higher level to lower level. It is a very important point. Water always flow from higher to lower level. You will never find that the water from the lower level it is moving up until unless you put any external pressure to it. So it will not move. So general tendency of water or any liquid is what? They flow from higher to lower level. And what about their free surface? In the solid I have told infinite many free surfaces are there, but in liquid other three sides are closed by the container. Only one free surface is there for a liquid. So liquid has only one free surface. We can take any example of our choice. Water is the very good example. Milk, kerosene, any type of oil you can take, any type of fruit juices you can take, okay, cold drinks and all you can take. These are the very good example which we find them in the liquid state. Now we will see the third states of matter, that is gas. Now let us see the characteristics of the gas. It has a definite mass. Obviously mass will be always definite because air also, gases also have mass, but no definite shape and volume. It has neither definite shape, neither definite volume. It's like the liquid, it also takes the shape of the container. You must have seen a balloon. When you blow a balloon, it takes the shape of the balloon. Whatever the shape of the balloon has been in the deflated condition, it when after giving the air, it also takes the shape of the balloon. When you buy any air tub, air filled tires and all, you will see after filling the air to it, it becomes the shape of the tire only. Okay, so no fixed shape. Now no definite volume, it takes the volume of the container. Now let us take an example. Suppose I have been provided with three types of container. One container is having 1 liter. Okay, it is 1 liter. Another container is 3 liters. Okay, and the third container I have taken which is 5 liters. Now I have been provided with, in a bottle, I have been provided with a 1/2 liter of chlorine gas. Chlorine gas is a very characteristic smell is there, and it has a definite colors also, greenish yellow gas. So when we put this chlorine in 1 liter, it will occupy the full 1 liter bottle of container fully. And when this same chlorine, 1/2 liter of chlorine, when we will give to the 3 liters, it will also occupy the 3 liters also. And when I will put this 1/2 liter chlorine to 5 liters also, it will occupy that also. In liquid and solid, we don't get this because they have a fixed volume. But in gases, we find that it takes the volume of the, whichever volume of the container it will be provided, it will always try to occupy that. Okay, so in this way we've taken example with a 1/2 liter chlorine, we provide it to 1 liter, it occupies it, 3 liters also it occupies it, 5 liters also occupies it. Then what will be the difference in their concentration? Concentration means here it will be very light smell will be there, here little bit harder smell, and here will be the hardest smell will be there. Let us see about the molecular arrangement of the gas. Molecular arrangement, you can see from this diagram also, the molecules are lying far apart from each other. Okay, they are far apart from each other. That's why what happened, the distance between them are what, very weak. The force will be very weak, and the distance is very large compared to liquid and solid. So the intermolecular force of attraction is very weak because they cannot pull each other, because they are so far away from each other that the intermolecular force of attraction pull is very negligible. And on the other hand, intermolecular space, you can see so much gap is there, so space is very large. These are the 3 characteristics of the molecular arrangement of a gas. Now coming to the properties, I have already told the first property, no definite shape and volume. Next is the, it flow in any direction. You just see the air surrounding us all the time, it can flow in any direction. When give a perfume to a room spray, when you give to a room, it doesn't go to the particular in one direction, it's just spread all over the room. So whatever the space will be provided to gas, it will always occupy it. So why it can occupy? Because it can flow or move in any direction. Now it can be compressed. It can be compressed, yes. When pressure will be applied, it can be compressed because there is so much gap. When you give a pressure to it, the molecules will try to come closer. And if they try to come closer, which state it will come? It will come to the liquid state. And that's why LPG gas, in our kitchen we use the LPG gas cylinder. The LPG gas cylinder, they are in the liquid state, but in this under pressure. So when pressure will be applied, these molecules will be coming closer and take the previous stage of the matter, that is liquid state. But when this pressure will be released again, it will again come back to the gaseous state. So it can be compressed because there is an intermolecular space is very large. Now it can spread to any large area available. I have told you the large area, how much area it can, you provide how much area, it will always occupy. Only the thing is there, the smell and the thickness of the concentration will be very less if you provide large area. Now about the pressure, it exert equal pressure in all direction. That means what, when you blow a balloon, you cannot say that the balloon's air will go in particular one direction. It will equally spread all over the side of the balloon, and the balloon will blow equal in all direction. That's why we find that the blowing balloon looks uniformly everywhere, it is uniform. Why? Because it exerts equal pressure in all direction. Okay, let us take one example of this. Well, it is also given in your book in page number 25. The activity 8, you will see that 3 containers have been taken. The first container is empty. Empty means it is filled with air because air is everywhere. Now the second container is filled with a specific color gas. You take bromine. Okay, bromine is a light brown color gas. Okay, but we have taken a full jar of bromine filled up with, that means the color will be very dense color, so it will be very brownish color. After this 2 jars we have taken, now we will put this jar on it. Why we are putting this jar on it? By opening the lids. After opening the lids, we find that the whatever color it contains, suppose it contains a very dark brown color, and air is colorless, and when we mix these two gases, then what happen? It will try to occupy the whole space here. So what happened? This brown color and the air goes on mixing to each other, and as a result, we will find the very light color you will find of the gas. So whatever the dark color you find of the bromine, it after mixing with the air, it gives a very light brown color of the gas after mixing. It proves that gas fill up the space, all the space available to it, because these are two gases, they fill up the space available to it. That's why we took one colored gas in order to understand the how much light it becomes. Okay students, so this is all about the properties, three states of gas, their definitions and their molecular arrangement with an examples. Okay, so many examples you have seen here. The air is a mixture of gases. Any examples you can give, air itself is an example. And other than air, hydrogen, nitrogen gas, carbon dioxide gas, sulfur dioxide gas, these are like this, various types of gas are there which can come under the category of gases. Chlorine gas also you can take, students. Just now I have given bromine. Bromine is not a gas, it is a liquid in normal temperature. So, but under the pressure we put it as a bromine gas here. Okay, in this way they mix up to each other. The three states of matter we have discussed in detail, students. Now in page number 25, in table 3.1, you will get the full distinguished properties of solid, liquid and gases. Please go through them nicely. The molecular structures of the gases I have discussed with you. Now we will talk about the three terms related to the molecular structure of the gases. What is the difference in properties of the three states of matter? The three states of matter differ in their properties also, in their characteristics also, in their molecular arrangement also. Then what is the reason behind it? Why they differ in their properties? Okay, so let us see what are the reasons for it. The reason is the, we have seen intermolecular force of attraction, intermolecular space, they move, okay, their movement. That's why the arrangement of the molecules also differ. So let us see the reasons one by one. First reason, intermolecular force of attraction. It is also known as cohesive force. Please remember this name, cohesive force. So you know that any matter is made up of particles or molecules. These molecules have some space in them. Solid have minimum space, liquid has little bit more than the solid, and gaseous has the maximum space in them. And that is why the intermolecular force of attraction between the solid is very strong, liquid is weaker, and gases are the weakest, because the space is very large. Okay, so intermolecular force is what? It is also known as the cohesive force. Why cohesive force? In a matter, molecules are attracted towards each other, and you know that in a particular matter, molecules are all same. So attraction between the like particles, like means same particles, attraction between the same particles of a particular matter is known as what? Cohesive force. So it is the largest in solid, little bit weaker in liquid, and gases it is the weakest. Now we will come to the second criteria, second reason, random motion of particles. We know that molecules always move in the spaces given to it. So in the solid we find that since there is no space, they always vibrate in their mean position. Okay, they cannot go so far away from each other, they only vibrate and shake in their mean position when it is heated or temperature is given, like that. So, and in liquid they can move little bit, and when temperature will be given, the movement will be very faster. And in gases, since the space is very large, they can move to any extent. So this type of movement, random motion of the particle, it is one of the very important characteristics of a or properties of a matter. So what is this random motion moving here and there? In the gases we find that it moves here and there, aimlessly moving here and there, not in a serial wise. So aimlessly moving, zigzag motion of the particles suspended in the medium. Medium means, if you take the medium water, suppose here I have taken the medium water and I have sprinkled some chalk powder on it. Then what we find after some time, that the chalk powder moves here and there. This movement, here and there movement in the water, and water acts as a medium here, and the chalk powders are the another particles which gets mixed into the medium. So the zigzag motion of the particles suspended in a medium. They are suspended. Chalk powder will never dissolve. So they will suspend in the water and they will move aimlessly here and there. This movement is known as what? Brownian movement, because it has been discovered. This movement has been discovered by a scientist known as Robert Brown. Okay. So Robert Brown has discovered this. That's why this name has come to Brownian movement. Now coming to the next reason, that is diffusion. We know that, again we will come back to the molecular structure. We know that in a solid, molecules are tightly packed, so they cannot diffuse so easily. Very minimum, least diffusion is there between. What is diffusion? Diffusion is intermixing of the particles of one kind to the particles of the other kind. We have seen that the two solids, if we keep the two solids together like this, then they will not mix because their molecules are tightly packed until and unless any external pressure is applied to it. Then only they will melt and they will mix. On the other hand, liquid compared to the solid, they can mix a little. So if you take liquid, also depends upon what type of liquid you are taking. If they are miscible, then only they will mix. If they are not miscible, they will not mix. Okay. And what about the gases? Gases have any state of mixing. Gases the best example of diffusion, because gases shows higher ability of the diffusion process occurs in gases. Gases shows the maximum diffusion. And the one gas mix, suppose chlorine and bromine, if I want to mix them, or the air is a very good example. You see where different types of gases are mixed together, like nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, all are mixed together. And gases are also matter. They are also made up of particles and they intermix with each other to any extent. Let us see now how diffusion process, that is the third reason, how it is affecting the three states of matter. First, diffusion is what I have defined, that the phenomenon of intermixing of particles of one kind to the another kind is known as what? Diffusion process. So in solid, you know that it is very rigid, molecules are very packed, so diffusion shows very little or almost negligible in solid. What about liquid? Liquid, since there is a little space between the molecules, so diffusion can take place slowly, but it depends upon what kind of the two liquids you have taken. If you have taken the two liquids which are miscible to each other, mix with each other, they are known as miscible liquid. And if the liquid, two liquids which do not mix with each other, they are known as immiscible liquid. It depends upon the type of the liquids you have taken. So let us take the example of miscible liquid, water and alcohol. They are easily mixing with each other, so diffusion is very much high in water and alcohol. But on the other hand, if I take water and oil, any type of oil, kerosene, petrol, mustard oil, refined oil, any oil, if you take with water, it is not mixing with each other. That's why diffusion is not possible in immiscible liquids. So it depends upon the type of liquids you have taken for diffusion. Now coming to the gases. In case of gases, diffusion, since you know the molecules are far apart and they have the ability to move in all direction, as well as they have the ability to occupy the space given to it, these all factors will affect the diffusion, and that's why diffusion is very fast in gases. Why? Because enough space is there, allow them to move freely and have the ability to mix up easily. So if you take two gases, I have shown you the jar one, that bromine gas and air, how it is mixing by the process of diffusion, they are mixing. Now above all this, one factor is applicable to everyone, that is external factor. If we give external factor, if we apply here, that is the temperature. If we apply temperature to all of these one by one, then the more the temperature you will apply, the more the diffusion will be taking place. Since in the solid, the diffusion is very least, that's why diffusion will be taking place after some time, and slowly, slowly it will increase. In liquid, since the diffusion is very slow, so it depends upon, and slowly if you increase the temperature, diffusion rate will also be increasing. But in gases, since the diffusion is in normal condition, only diffusion is very, very fast, and when you apply pressure temperature to it, it will be very fast in the gases. So this is all about the diffusion process. So students, I have explained the three states of matter, their properties, their characteristics, the molecular arrangement and intermolecular structure of the three states of matter. So please learn them from your book. Try to learn the tables which I have told you. Now that's all for today. Take care of your health. Have a nice day. Thank you.